Let's look at some of the arguments against monorail. Monorails are not environment friendly. Because they are elevated, it is said that monorails create a tunnel effect along the roads they follow. However, modern monorails are environment friendly. New techniques in construction have resulted in very slender beams and slender pylons. These beams are only 26 inches wide. Monorails are designed to be attractive and can be considered an enhancement to the environment rather than an eyesore. How is it that narrow beams like this can be considered obtrusive? It could be argued that light rail isn't environment friendly, considering the many aerial wires and supports required. Both light and heavy rail guideways are much larger than that of monorail and take up much more space when elevated or at ground level. Also, if monorails are such an eyesore, why did Los Angeles voters favor monorail 5-1 over other alternatives, including heavy rail and light rail? Why did voters in Seattle vote for monorail system expansion while transit officials supported a far more expensive light rail plan? Why would the number one resort destination in the world select monorail to carry millions of passengers each year? Simply put, people like monorails. Monorails can be designed to blend in with the surrounding environment. A good example of this is the Sydney monorail. In environment-sensitive areas, the track features low-cost mirrored stanchions with marbled bases. Generous landscaping along the route can enhance the urban environment, as has been done on the Kitakyushu monorail in Japan. Monorails have problems switching. This is an old myth dating back to the Wuppertal monorail. The Wuppertal monorail opened in 1901 and does have limitations. Its switches are cumbersome and slow. However, many new technologies have been developed in both suspended monorails and straddle monorails since 1901. Around the world, monorail switches operate with 100% reliability. They have to be reliable or many monorail systems cannot function. For example, this switch in Tokyo has been operating flawlessly every few minutes since 1964. This suspended monorail switch and many more like it must operate to allow bi-directional travel on the Shonan monorail system. The technology of modern monorail switching is efficient and well proven. Emergency evacuation of monorails is difficult. Although monorail train failure is rare, evacuation of a distressed monorail vehicle can happen in several ways. In the case of Newark International, an emergency walkway follows the entire route. For systems without walkways, emergency procedures can include train-to-train transfers via ramps. Even so, there are many monorails that operate without walkways or ramps, and the monorail safety record remains unparalleled. Stations are expensive and obtrusive. Because monorails are quiet and have powerful gradient climbing capabilities, monorail stations can be built almost anywhere. With clever architecture and engineering, stations can be built above city streets or freeways. They can also be built at ground level. And they can be built on the sides of buildings. Because the trains are so quiet, they can even be built inside buildings. Yes, a monorail station can be more expensive than a ground-level light rail station. However, the long-term benefits of monorail, along with lower operating costs, far outweigh any potential higher capital costs for building monorail stations. The turn radius of monorail requires a large area. Since monorails can follow their own path rather than always following streets, they usually aren't required to make tight turns as light rail does. Still, the turn radius of this type of monorail is only 53 meters. Other manufacturers can match this, and some can do even better. For instance, here is a tight turn on Sydney, Australia's downtown monorail. Monorails are costly to build. Let's look at the MGM Valley's monorail in Las Vegas. This system includes about 1 mile of dual beam guideway, two high-capacity stations, a train maintenance and storage facility, and 2 6-car trains. The entire cost for this system was around $25 million. Monorail costs vary greatly. It depends on alignment conditions, the technology selected, and the cost of right-of-way acquisition. Monorail capital costs are competitive with the average light rail system, yet the performance and safety of monorail are vastly superior. Not only that, because of their low operating expense, monorails can turn a profit. This has been proven with the Tokyo Monorail, the Seattle Monorail, and others. Light rail or heavy rail systems do not turn a profit, but monorail can. Anyone studying rail transit should include a 30-year operating expense analysis before deciding upon the technology to use. Heavy rail and light rail cost much more in the long run than monorail, no matter which is more expensive to construct. Monorail technology is proprietary. It is sometimes said that because there are less manufacturers of monorails than that of other forms of rail transit, replacement equipment can only be obtained from the original supplier. As a result, costs are higher. To counter this argument, consider the Walt Disney World monorail system. In the late 1980s, when the aging fleet of 12 Mark IV trains were in need of replacement, contract bids for the new trains came in from manufacturers from all over the world. If there is a need for equipment, numerous manufacturers can supply. The same is true for track. As more monorails are built, more suppliers will get involved and prices can be even further reduced. Monorail construction is disruptive. Installation of pylons takes up little space. Rather than having an entire street dug up as with light rail or subway, only small holes are necessary for pylon foundations. Monorail guideways and pylons are built off-site. Both are trucked to the construction site and quickly lifted into place. After about 8 months of engineering, the MGM Valley system was installed in only 5 months of construction. Monorails are unproven in transit applications. Anyone who says this is either unaware of the facts or they are being deceitful. As we have shown, monorails have been proving themselves in transit applications around the world for years, and they continue to do so today. The time has come for decision makers to choose an attractive, faster, profitable, more efficient, and far safer type of rail to transport people. Do we want to continue down the same path of the past? Or do we want a better future? The choice is clear, and the answer is monorail. For further information, visit the Monorail Society website at monorails.org. That's monorails with a S, .org.